Namaskar. Welcome to today's edition of Holistic Healing. We are going to talk about a complication which is not a disease but is now one of the major issues. It is uric acid, elevated level of uric acid. Ironically, our previous generation probably hadn't even heard about it. It was not an issue for anybody, but today most of the medical reports tell you that your uric acid level is high and you have to worry about it. And the worry is genuine. There is reason for it. Why? Because one, it causes gout. And anybody who has had this problem knows that it is so painful. It causes a lot of pain. And in later stages, it also causes kidney problems. So you have to be very careful. You have to keep it under check. And it is entirely in our hands because it is not a disease. It happens only because we have changed our dietary habits drastically. We have gone absolutely wrong in our how much we eat and what we eat. We should go step by step over that. All that happens is that, see, your digestion is like something burning in a fireplace. Wherever something is burnt, there are bound to be some byproducts like smoke and ash. Similarly, you can compare your digestive process as a burning process. There are bound to be some byproducts. So, uric acid is one of the byproducts. Whichever foods have too much of purines, the byproduct is uric acid. And in layman's terms, you can call it any high protein diet has uric acid as byproduct. What are the biggest culprits? All non-vegetarian foods. Whenever we eat them, the byproduct would be uric acid, and uric acid in simple terms means pains. Keep it to controlled limit, you'll be fine. I'm not asking you to turn vegetarian overnight. All I'm saying is that you cannot eat more than what your body can digest. See, meat was a luxury. Meat was an occasional pastime. You could eat it all, maybe in a fortnight or so. That was a standard practice. Today we have made it into our staple diet. We think that just because we have got money, we can eat it every day. Sorry, it cannot happen. If you eat too much of it, this is the price you will have to pay. So that will be your first target. Unfortunately, we do not cut down on the main target, but we think of other things which are not that harmful. The main focus normally goes to pulses. For a person who has already got gout, it is necessary to cut them out totally, but it doesn't mean that you have to totally eliminate them from your diet. They have to be part of a balanced diet. You cannot have too much of them, but in right quantity they are okay. Unfortunately, our country is so poor that most people have to survive on their roti and dal or rice and dal. If you have it in that copious quantity, then there's bound to be trouble. Otherwise, don't be too scared about pulses. They are a good source of nutrition. You cannot totally eliminate them. Don't be too concerned. In fact, some people are also scared about eating certain leafy vegetables. The biggest bugbear is your spinach. Even experts tell you to eliminate spinach. What is lost sight of is that you have to eat it in huge quantities. Only a goat can eat that much. You don't have to be so concerned about your spinach. In normal quantities, it's okay. Please differentiate between a person who has already got this disease and a normal person. That one bowl of spinach that you eat is perfectly okay. Nobody can eat too much. Only when you got this disease, only then you are in trouble. So, merely by changing your food habits, you can get rid of this problem. If at all you've got it, you have to take some special measures. Again, mostly concerned with your food. Do a few things and you'll be able to cure it without any medicine. Here are a few do's and don'ts. The first thing you have to be very particular is that if you have high levels of uric acid, totally and completely eliminate all alcoholic drinks. They will ruin your health. They are the first biggest factor that you have to cut out. And of course, we have already talked about meat that has to go out, and you have to also eliminate your alcohol. And as you must have noticed, these things go hand in hand. Most people who love their non-vegetarian food love their alcohol also, and vice versa. So eliminate that strongly. While you are reducing your alcohol, at the same time increase certain things. Water intake should be greatly increased. Anybody suffering from high uric acid should drink large quantity of water. That will help you in flushing out uric acid from the system. Strangely, some people say that we don't like the taste of water, whereas it is totally a tasteless liquid. But if at all you have this issue, all you have to do is that there are certain additives you can put to your water to make it palatable to your kind of taste. One thing is adding lemon to it. Lemon will make it taste better, and in any case, lemon itself helps in reducing your uric acid. So add that freely. In fact, not only lemon, even oranges and other citric fruits can also be used to the same effect. The only precaution is that you should not be adding sugar to that, because that is no good. It will cause you more harm. Keep that off. Then you can boil a few other things also with your water, which will make it taste better. It could be your fennel seeds, it could be cinnamon powder, these things, and cardamom also. You can try out these three combinations. I mean, you can put them together, or you can try out all three of them. They will also go good with that. Another thing you can add to your water is your normal soda bicarb, the baking soda. That also is a great help. Coming down to solid food items, tomatoes are very good in reducing this. Lemon, apple cider vinegar, and for that matter any other vinegar, as long as it is not synthetic, will also help in reducing the gout and other problems. Cherries are very good. All forms of berries are excellent also. So these normal things would help you. Please remember, we are herbivores. We have to mostly eat green things. All of them are helping you. And all the processed food that we have created is the root cause of uric acid. Change your lifestyle, change your habits, and it'll be good. And the old favorite thing, your exercise, is essential for keeping your body in good order and eliminating all the waste. Any byproduct that accumulates in your system is bound to create problems. Keep off them and you'll be better off.